again, and welcome back to XCOM The Long War. If I remember correctly, I have a landed UFO to deal with. One thing I did forget to do. I should really equip these out for speed rather than anything else. Everything weighs one, doesn't it? Yeah, weighs one. I suppose I could completely strip the flashbangs and such to lower their weight and give them SMG for extra movement. So plus 3 movement, I mean, that would be quite handy actually. I mean, if you're going to take a scout, you really should spec the scout for movement. That's after what they're for. I could probably, adding an SMG and dropping one of the flashbangs, give a total of plus 4 movement, which is actually pretty decent. An increase. I won't lie, I am very tempted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I still have 5 flashbangs. That should be plenty for a single UFO. So yeah, I'm gonna do that. I may end up regretting it because it means massively lowering damage output. Yeah, 19 movement, that's not too bad. I mean, the lack of damage output and the lack of hit points really do concern me. But, sack it. Let's try. I think there was something else I was contemplating changing, but I can't recall what it was now.
The alien craft set down in a remote area. Securing the site is our top priority. As always, we should eliminate any remaining hostiles in the area.
Absolutely, Brad. I shall endeavor to do so. Once the game actually loads, of course. Oh, come on. Yeah, I mean, scouts are supposedly there for mobility, spotting enemies, uncovering pods, etc, etc. But I don't know, it's
we're in position near the enemy LZ. Strike one is ready to move on your orders.
I read you, Big Sky. This was a landing, not a crash, so expect heavy resistance.
Yeah. Was indeed a landing rather than a crash. Yes. Ah, UFO's over there. So I'm thinking I'll head off to the right. Must work out which position all these go in. What did we see? I don't remember seeing anything. I mean, we uncovered something somewhere. I just don't know what or where. Well, that's fucking terrifying. Okay. Drone, couple of sectoids. Wow, 81%, yeah. Prevent it from flanking us as well. Okay, so you realistically want to just duck behind cover. If you could go there, that'd be reasonably safe. Set up potential flanks. I mean, that one that is currently flanked is obviously going to move. I don't think you'll be able to get a shot from there, but oh, you will. 44, not fantastic. Let's just leave you for a moment. 37 is not bad, but we really want you behind some form of cover. Gone up to 52, getting there. Mr. Scout, you really want to go forward. Oh, Scout, assault. We really want the assaults to go forward super aggressively. So you can get off some potential run and gun action in the turns to come. but we don't want to go too far in that direction in case we pop any more pods. So I think you will actually join your mate just over there. So let's reevaluate our shots. 37, 52, 52, 44, 29. Okay, what we're going to do actually is... it's sorely tempting, especially if you have a pop at that one. Because that one has no incentive to move. That one has an incentive to move and get caught by the Overwatch. That one does not. So, 50-50 is not great, but I'll take it. Yeah. Yeah. So I could have steadied up or something instead. Oh, really? The reaction is worse? Oh, but we hit it anyway. I'm surprised the Overwatch shot was worse than the shot in cover though. That's a bit peculiar. Okay. They're gonna train us into another pod, which is somewhat irritating. It's only half cover. It could be an Overwatch, but she has lightning reflexes. Now, obviously she can't kill either of them because she's only got an SMG. But she can at least do a bit of damage. That one would have 243% chances. What's really concerning me is that the UFO is right there. Me just in case I manage to uncover sufficient vision to trigger another pod, especially with that one in a potentially awkward position as it is. I might do instead. It's only half cover, but it's probably going to run away anyway. So that one at the back there is probably going to leg it. The outsider worries me. As does the fact that it landed, so I know there are going to be more around. Shot, but you can go somewhere. You can possibly get a shot next turn. Running. And you medic again. I don't want to put them there just in case of unpleasantness, so let's just all bunch up behind that log. Sectoid running like hell? Possibly? Can't see. Yeah, he's running. Doesn't hugely surprise me. Yeah, I'm probably not going to get that meld. Because what I really want to do is bring this scout up to unveil the rest of this map. Okay, I don't think there's going to be any more pods there, so we can actually begin doubling back. Making a move towards the meld. Hopefully without uncovering pods. Take a little half move there. Okay, that's fine. So we know that will be fine. Sniper. Got it covered. want. Let's see in there with steadied weapon just in case. Scout, just run like hell back. Again, we know this area is going to be safe, so I've got no problems leaving him out in the open there. And you likewise can just form up a little square. Now, there's not a lot of cover around there, if I'm honest. I think I hear floaters. Scout up, being a little concerned about possibly revealing something. Yeah, it's a lot of things we don't really want, but we dashing across that cover is the only option we realistically have. See, yeah, unfortunately dashing all the way up here, it's super risky, but it's the only option we have, so come across one more, shouldn't uncover any extra vision. Quite a long move actually, Zhang. Again, just going to sit in a nice tight pack, perfect for a grenade, but yeah, be weak. Losing on, not using that square there, it's just diagonal field of vision can be a bit funky at times. You steady up, and you reload, may as well. Yeah, obviously there are aliens in there. Just hope they don't patrol onto me while I'm so completely screwed. What do we got? Floater, 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 floater. Unit of Overwatch right at the back there. Now, does my sniper have a shot? No, because it's only a marksman's rifle, not a full-on sniper rifle. We creep forwards, can we get range? Just. It's not a great shot, but it's the only shot that sniper's going to get for a little while. Yeah. Could have steadied. Maybe should have steadied, but, now this will draw out the Overwatch, but it is super risky because it means easily flanked by a floater next turn. However, I can suppress that floater that's in flanking position. So let's just draw the Overwatch. It always worries me, even when they've got such low percent, ever since that rookie died to a 1% shot. This is now that Overwatch is done. Can we run and gun anywhere good-ish? Can hop up there, but that's still going to have full cover from us. Yeah, no matter where we run and gun, they're still going to have full cover from us, aren't they? Is it worth taking the risk? There's not really anywhere you can even advance into cover, is there? Infantry's at 248s. It would be nice, because it would buy us a little bit of breathing room. And take your second shot. Yeah, the issue is that they are completely unprotected. Now you just have such terrible shots. Could smoke these. There's a great deal of really happy fun times cover, is there? Let's just move you up there for the time being. Yeah, I am concerned that one shot, which means it is I don't know why it's still giving me the blue things, because it can't actually move. I'm seriously concerned he's going to get hit if I don't do something. Trouble is that... Yeah, that one doesn't have... we can suppress that one. And we can't realistically get a shot on it. What we can do is run that around. And that's quite easily flanked as well. No matter where they go, it's getting flanked from somewhere. I mean, we can suppress the front one easily. Those probably aren't going to advance far enough. Especially if I just use you on Overwatch. If you suppress the front. Could use a flush, I suppose, but... And you have no cover to hide in other than there. I mean, could go there, but... Don't realistically want to go there, if I'm honest. Going up there gives a chance of a running gun, but I'm not feeling it. I suppose just dashing into half. I don't like taking half cover, but left without a huge deal of options. Just chosen to Overwatch. Okay then. So if you go there, you've got the flank shot, or actually go there. You're in cover from those, you've got the flank shot on that, you've got lightning reflexes to screw up their Overwatch shot. You've also got a flashbang, in fact. We'll leave that decision until after we've grabbed the melt and had a look at what everyone else has got. See, the flank on that is tempting because it guarantees the kill. What else have I got hanging around here? I've got my rather useless, if I'm honest, sniper. Just cannot get a good shot for love nor money. But you can steady weapon this turn. So what have you got? Again, the problem there is the cover. I've got a run and gun, flank, kill. So, scout, shoot, kill, run and gun, flank, kill. That one, suppress. Or flush. Doesn't have line of sight. But if that's the only one left, we could move that one over to there. And then we'd probably get line of sight. What else have we got? Your shots are just terrible. We've even got double shotgun running guns as a possibility, but we're going to have to go first things first. That one there has to die. Okay, that makes this substantially worse. Fine, just take... no, don't do that. Move up into cover, then take your shot. It's a coin flip, but that miss from that scout really hurt us. I mean, really hurt us. I mean, that one there has got to be killed or suppressed now, because the scout's in such a shitty position because of that miss. Please tell me you get line of sight on it from there. Yeah, okay, but suppressing. Still got a couple potential running guns. Now, please do not fuck this up. If they miss or if they trigger another pod, they are absolutely fucked. Another option is just moving up and flashbanging, which I think I'm going to take the safer option. Oh, that scout missing his host is so badly. And you can do an awful fucking lot in all honesty. Move forwards. Improve your chances at all? Not massively. Is that we'll take a random pot shot? No. Yeah, we will. Tempted by the overwatch? Yeah. I mean, my 50-50 shots have not been paying off brilliantly. Okay. Oh, that's that fucking sectoid. Okay, Mr. Sawgunner. Jesus. Really fucking need you to land the hit and the crit. The assault gunner doesn't have the ammo to do a damn thing. Okay. You're out of ammo, aren't you? Yep. Okay, you can get in half cover. Pretty much definitely kill that. Freeze up the scout. That one can realistically do nothing except advance. Actually, maybe just nudge around into full cover for an overwatch instead. If you were to go up there, could you get a flashbang off? Let's find out. So, I mean, your flashbang is fairly irrelevant because you can't actually throw it. The issue is, I think, going to be that, but if I can free up my scout to go around, do that. Oh, that's risky. It's risky no matter which way we do it. Really? You're not actually flanking from there? How is that not a flank? I mean, it's there. You are right there. Exactly where is that getting cover from? I suppose that is here. He's one across. Okay then. Sectoid. Can we get you into any sort of decent range slash cover situation? Not really. God damn it, I thought for certain I'd have a flank. You can do nothing due to suppression. You can do nothing because you just have no ammo. Even if you had a shot. I don't like using half cover, but I've got to get it into position so it can do something next turn. So I mean, that has to move. Because otherwise it's going to get shot by two seekers. Seeker, if you don't get the hell out of the way. We're just going to have to risk the overwatch fire. There's nothing realistically can be done about that, is there? 56%. But it's guaranteed to die anyway from the seekers if I stayed there. Okay, game, why have you frozen? Game? That must have made it. And the animation was just going a bit mental. Okay, they've gone stealth instead of shooting. That's... Oh yeah, they have no flank to target anymore, do they? Okay, they're falling back, gives us time to regroup. I'm actually quite happy with that. And that one's had to reload. Okay, so... Of course, you don't have a running gun available, do you? Why would you? Trouble is, where the hell did that seeker go? Still not out of the woods yet. It means putting you in a precarious position. So I don't know where that seeker went or whether it went into overwatch. Oh, it's in there. And you're still not able to... Motherfucking son of a... This is such fucking bullshit. Fine, just flush him out. Don't tell me we've got the bug where flush doesn't actually work. Yeah, we have. Right, now since those stickers are in stealth mode, you are not safe. All the way back there on your jack. Oh, I hate wasting a flashbang on that one bloody arsehole. But the flash not actually working. I'm not seeing any options at all. You're just gonna have to reload. What have you got? You got a shot. Since we flashed, it's probably, yeah, well. Let's just creep forwards a bit. Sniper. Doesn't really surprise me. So if you could just finish that one off. Great work, Shang. And then reload. You know what? Fuck that floater. Moving out. I need to get rid of that bastard. What seeker? Where the fuck is that seeker? Fucking seriously? Seriously? Yeah, you're not gonna do a damn thing. Oh, Jesus Christ. I mean, I couldn't even see that seeker. Come on, you had it there a minute ago. Of course, they're immune to flashbangs, which I'd completely forgotten. Okay, so that shotgunner is in fact dead. Seeker doesn't get it, the floater will.
Location confirmed.
Going in for the kill. There's no way you can go where you're gonna have good cover from that floater. Now I don't think you can actually one shot a seeker, but oh thank fuck for that. Finally looking up ever so fucking slightly. Not a lot. I'd love to have, you know, a chance to regroup a bit.
Let's do this.
You know, reload, get everyone sorted.
I'm rolling.
Get people healed up.
Easy now, soldier.
I think there's still one more seeker in stealth mode that's gonna turn up and annoy us at some point, but
yes, sir.
It's a problem for another time.
Got it covered.
Should be a hotkey for steady weapon, they really should.
I have it covered. Reloaded.
Good to go. It should be.
Okay, we're all fully loaded again. As healed as we're gonna get. So we've still got one floater kicking around. I'm absolutely certain there is a seeker kicking around as well. It's possible I was misremembering, but I'm pretty damn certain there was another seeker around here. So we don't want to spread out too far. Maybe it had unstealthed. Actually no, that probably was the last seeker. It just went into stealth plus overwatch instead of stealth plus attacking, which I didn't even know they could do. I didn't even know that was an option for them. Yeah, that floater. I'm just gonna have to engage the floater along with the outsider. Oh, or maybe you will come back. That's a fairly crappy shot. No one else has a better one, I don't think. You for now, see what it does. Okay, it's moved there. Only 57, but gotta take it. Oh, thank Christ. Okay, so just the overseer to worry about. Outsider, rather. So that means we move into breaching positions. Through the corners, but that should not be too big a chance, realistically. Now going there risks revealing, so we'll just go there instead. Do I want to get the sniper? Gunner into forward positions first. I mean, it can't hurt really, can it? If we could sneak all the way around to flank it, but I think we're just going to do this old school. Let's just have you open the door, see which side it runs to.
I've got something over here.
There's one over there. Of course you don't quite have the movement range, do you? You don't have a flashbang left. Do, but you don't quite have the movement range. Actually, maybe it does. I mean, that's as close as we're going to get. Let's just try it. If not, we can always run back out. Oh, yeah. Here, if I'm honest, you think can move far enough to realistically cause any concerns. Let's just overwatch since we've got opportunist. Medic, not looking super likely if I'm honest. However, dashing around there. I mean, half cover with these outsiders are generally so accurate that half cover is dodgy as hell. But it has been flashbanged, so you never know. That's when I find out the fucker's actually got some grenades as an option. Wow. Once you run all the way around there, we're not going to, we're just going to run. Oh, don't tell me you can't actually run. No, that square's got to be run throughable. I would hope. That's got to be a connected spot of land, hasn't it? Yeah, 88%, that's a hell of a shot. Double moved and flanked himself. Sensible though, because it means none of this lot can kill it. However, you've got a flank. And my shotgunner. Also sitting there waiting for him. Yeah, if I hadn't thought to sneak him out the back, this would be a bit trickier. I've got the crit anyway. Yeah, that was absolutely textbook. Flash, and sprint round the back to jam a shotgun up his ass. I'm quite pleased with the way that mission turned out. Lots of promotions, yeah, a bit of a wound, but can't have everything. Okay. I see all of these are always tempting. I'm never entirely sure what to go for here. I quite like Will to Survive, because they do need more will. And the extra damage reduction is also very nice. We have aggression for crit chance. Considering how often they are surrounded by enemies, it's good. And good old plus one damage. It does work on everything after all. See, I mean, most of the choices are actually quite easy for a lot of these, but that is... it's a tricky one. I think I'm gonna go for the crit. We're always surrounded by aliens after all. Low profile, standard sniper stuff. Medic. Again, tricky to choose, but I think I'm gonna have to go for field surgeon, aren't I? And that's the easy choice. Close combat specialist. Nice thing about landed ones is you do get nice amounts of illyrium, computers, etc. Auto lasers, laser rifles, lots of things coming in. At some point this month, we are definitely going to end up with.
The new engineers arrived this morning, Commander. We're always glad to have more help down here.
Rebuild ship end of the month. But we are definitely going to end up with what we could do with this. Excavating that so we can stick another lab in. I'm also seriously tempted to put a steam generator there. It's going to be so long before I actually get the rest of my satellites. I can always delete it once I've got the Illyrium generators up and running. How is our research?
To support the research team, Commander. I've already put the new recruits to work in the lab.
15 days, and then there's the build time as well. Probably not going to have beam lasers till next month. But yeah, my exalt issues should also be starting quite soon. Ah, but first we have a terror mission. Wondrous. And it's a waterfront terror mission, so first things first, we have one engineer available. We have a rocketeer available. I'm thinking this is a sort of mission where I really want my close combat specialist assaults as well, just in case Chrysalids get close. I mean, they shouldn't. What else to bring is a question. I mean, I've got an awful lot of people out fatigued and still a fuck ton of wounded. Scout, possibly not a bad idea. I don't like taking specialists on terror missions, but one engineer, one rocketeer, one assault, one scout, one infantry. I mean, maybe medic. I mean, the fact is, yeah, medkits are no good against chrysalids, but they are still handy for the inevitable, I don't know, floaters, seekers, whatever the hell it is the game's going to throw at us. So that's really a choice of, do I want an infantry or a gunner? I think I'm going to go for the gunner. Right, so you are shotgun, double flashbang. You're a rocketeer, so you are, I think maybe a shredder rocket, actually, more useful than a standard, if I can find the shredder rocket. Scope, definitely, and there's the shredder rocket, and a laser rifle, infantry, obviously laser rifle, scope, maybe a flashbang, maybe ceramic armor. I mean, ceramic armor is not going to do a lot against a lot of the things we're facing down here. Still don't have my laser gun, do I? Nope. Definitely a scope. And a medic, laser rifle. We'll go for a scope. Scout. Scout I kind of want, again, take SMG in a vest, just to bring their speed up. I will drop a flashbang as well. 21 speed, they can actually outrun a chrysalid, I think. Engineer, I think double AP, double HE seems reasonable. I've run out of laser rifles. What's your aim? 69. It was a 68, so I'll tell you what. You can take your regular assault rifle. Engineer. And take the last laser. Double AG, double AP, shredder scope, double flash, single flash, scope medkit, scope backup medkit. Yeah, that seems pretty reasonable to me, so I should go back to briefing, because obviously I shall be actually continuing that mission next time. Once again, thank you very much for watching.